है, सो वी स्टार्ट, आई शेयर द स्क्रीन। Okay, now you can see I was just explaining you what would be the, based on the output voltage, you can see based on the output voltage, what there are different regions of the operations which we have to understand. So you can see here on the output voltages, so you can see along x-axis you have output voltage. Okay, so the output voltage will be, obviously we start from zero. Why? Because your capacitor is going to charge, it will take some time to charge, so obviously it will take some microsecond or nanoseconds to charge out, so we are just taking that small duration of time, because your output voltage will increase from zero and it will go to the VDD value. So this you have to understand, we start from zero and it will go to the VDD. So between charging from, means between going from 0 volt to VDD, there are three regions of operation which you should understand. And what is that? So you can see region 1, in which your output voltage is up to V threshold voltage of PMOS. So obviously this is your PMOS, so it is going to have some threshold voltage, so VT of P. And similarly, you have NMOS here, so it's also going to have some threshold voltage, VT of N. Okay, so when your output voltage is increasing from zero and it reaches to VTP. Now remember that the threshold voltage for PMOS is going to be lesser than zero, means it is going to be negative value. So here, that's why here you have the mod, and output voltage will start from zero and it will charge to the positive value. तो मतलब हम लोग यहाँ पे नेगेटिव वैल्यू तो पहुँच ही नहीं रहे हैं, तो हम लोग इसका मॉड दे रहे हैं। मॉड मतलब सपोज इफ योर वी टी पी वैल्यू, इफ योर वी टी पी इज माइनस वन वोल्ट, सो व्हेन यू टेक द मॉड ऑफ दैट, सो इट विल बी इक्वल टू प्लस वन वोल्ट, बिकॉज मॉड वैल्यू ऑलवेज टेकन एज पॉजिटिव। सो व्हेन योर आउटपुट वोल्टेज इज स्टार्टिंग टू इंक्रीज फ्रॉम जीरो टू मॉड ऑफ वी टी पी, मतलब अप टू वन वोल्ट, वॉट इज द स्टेट ऑफ द टू ट्रांजिस्टर, सो यू कैन सी द एनमॉस विल बी इन सैचुरेशन, because obviously the drain to source voltage is more than the gate to source voltage, no, because gate to source voltage is decreased by VTM, no? So NMOS will be in saturation and PMOS also will be in saturation, means when your output voltage is in between 0 to threshold voltage of P, both transistors in saturation. As soon as the output voltage crosses the VTP, because we have the capacitor there, so capacitor ka voltage charge ho raha hai, matlab capacitor is getting charged, so voltage goes on increasing. When that voltage, charging voltage, crosses threshold voltage of P, and so in that case, as soon as crosses the threshold voltage of P, so PMOS will change its operation or region of operation. So from saturation, it will go in the linear K, in linear region. So you can see after saturation, after crossing VTP of the output voltage, the PMOS goes in linear region while NMOS still remains in the saturation. So this is a region 2. Now, up to what voltage this condition will satisfy? Up to VDD minus VTN, matlab both NMOS ki taraf ja raha hai. Means obviously VDD minus VTN, which is also equal to VGS of the NMOS, is also equal to gate to source voltage for NMOS, hai na? This is same as gate to source voltage of NMOS. The same as gate to source voltage of NMOS. So when your output voltage reaches to VDD minus VTN, so up to that point, this region 2 will be there. As soon as Vout becomes greater than VDD minus VTN, मतलब आपका output voltage जो है ये गेट टू सोर्स वोल्टेज से जैसे क्रॉस करेगा ऑफ एनमॉस, एनमॉस डायरेक्टली गोज इन कट ऑफ। व्हाई इट विल गो इन कट ऑफ? बिकॉज इनपुट वोल्टेज जो यहाँ से वीडीडी आ रहा है और आउटपुट वोल्टेज जो difference in voltage hai. Now you know that in what condition you have the current flowing. I'm just asking the very basic question here. You let me know. If suppose you have the voltage here 5 volt, east terminal pe 5 volt hai, and you have the voltage here which is also 5 volt, are you able to get the current in between? What is the current flowing between these two points? I'm just asking the basic concept, because you are in the third year and this concept you should be aware. If suppose the voltage at this node, node A, and we can call this node A and this one is node B. If the voltage at this node A is 5 volt and voltage at this node is also 5 volt, what current will flow in between these two voltage? What is value of I? Let me know in the chat box, or you can unmute yourself, you can tell me the answer. Because this is a very basic concept. But once you understood this concept, then you'll understand why this NMOS board will cut off. So let me know in the chat box whether the current will flow or not. Reply fast. I can't have that much time to wait. Very good, Kripal. It is zero. Can you just let us know why it is zero? Those who are satisfying with the zero, very good. Those who are in confusion, like what could be the answer? Can you, Kripal, can you unmute yourself? Can you just say why it would be zero? The answer is correct. That is very correct. Short. No, short to abhi bhi hai. Suppose, theek hai, ek kaam karte hain. Same concept will apply here also. Suppose you have another circuit, you also, again you have the voltage here. So this is your 5 volt and this is your 2 volt, okay? And you're connecting between them, okay? You have A here and you have B node. What would the current in this case? Will it be zero? Because this is also a short condition. Kripal, this is also a short condition because we have A and node B directly shorted. So this is also short condition. In this case, will there be a current or not? Because if by that condition, if I is equal to zero, there should also no current, but it is not right.
Sir.
Yes.
There will be no current because the resistance is not present in between, means it can be infinite.
See, a resistance present hoga. See, the resistance is used to control the current. Resistance is used to control the current. Because, for example, agar aap LED lete ho, if you directly connect to the 5 volt or higher voltage, wo short ko fatak se break ho jayega because it crosses the burning voltage of the LED. So if you put the resistance in its path, so that resistance will control the currents automatically. जो पावर डिसिपेशन होगा उस एलईडी पे वो उतना नहीं होगा कि वो बर्न आउट हो जाए. सो रेजिस्टेंस इज यूज्ड टू कंट्रोल द
करंट. सर, इन सेकंड कंडीशन आई थिंक करंट विल फ्लो बिकॉज़ डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू नोड वोल्टेज इज नॉट जीरो.
यस, सो दिस इज द कांसेप्ट व्हिच आई वांटेड टू टेल यू. आपने शॉर्ट लिखा, सो दैट इज नॉट द कांसेप्ट. हियर द कांसेप्ट इज करंट ऑलवेज फ्लोस फ्रॉम व्हेन देयर इज द डिफरेंस इन द वोल्टेजेस. This is a very important concept. Remember that. If there is up two point le rahe ho. Yes, very good, Raghuram. If you have two points, and if those two points are at equipotential, there is no current flows between the two points if you short them together. Like example of Wheatstone bridge, if you can just recollect or remember, Wheatstone bridge mein hum log kya karte the? Wheatstone bridge mein galvanometer ke through current flow nahi hota hai. Kyun? Kyunki aapka wo dono point. जो दोनों पॉइंट जिसके बीच में आपका गैल्वेनोमीटर कनेक्ट होता है, दैट बोथ द पॉइंट्स आर एट इक्विपोटेंशियल. दे आर नॉट जीरो बट दे आर एट इक्विपोटेंशियल. बिकॉज ऑफ द इक्विपोटेंशियल करंट डज नॉट हैव द पाथ टू फ्लो. बिकॉज अगर दोनों जगह से सेम वोल्टेज आ रहा है, सो देर विल बी नो करंट फ्लोइंग. बिकॉज आई कैन से दैट यहाँ से भी सेम पुश, मतलब अगर सपोज एक वी कैन हैव करंट मीन्स एक सिंपल एक स्पेस ले लो वायर, उसके बीच में बहुत सारे इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हैं. यहाँ से भी सेम पुश मिल रहा है, यहाँ से भी सेम पुश मिल रहा है, तो देर विल बी नो करंट फ्लोइंग बिकॉज करंट को इलेक्ट्रॉन्स को फ्लो होने के लिए फोर्स ही नहीं है, बिकॉज यहाँ से भी सेम फोर्स मिल रहा है, यहाँ से भी सेम फोर्स मिल रहा है, तो दे विल नॉट फ्लो, दे विल रिमेन एट देयर पोजिशन ओनली, बिकॉज दैट रीजन यू डोंट हैव करंट फ्लोइंग. वेरी सिंपल कॉन्सेप्ट है, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड कि आपका एक वायर है, यहाँ से अगर आपको पुशअप मिला, फोर्स का फुल पुश मिला, सो ऑब्वियसली इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विल फ्लो इन द आउटवर्ड डायरेक्शन, बट यहाँ से भी अगर सेम पुश मिल रहा है तो वॉट विल हैपन, द इलेक्ट्रॉन विल फ्लो नेवर, बिकॉज यहाँ से भी इतना ही फोर्स, इतना यहाँ से भी इतना ही फोर्स, सो फोर्स होने की वजह से, इक्वल फोर्स होने की वजह से दे विल रिमेन देयर ओनली. बट सपोज यहाँ से फोर्स 5 वोल्ट का मिल रहा है, मतलब यहाँ से फोर्स 5 न्यूटन का मिल रहा है, यहाँ से 2 न्यूटन का ही मिल रहा है, तो यहाँ का फोर्स ज़्यादा है, दम शरास खेलेंगे हम लोग वहाँ पे, सॉरी दम शरास नहीं, क्या बोलते उसको, रस्सी खींचते ना, वेयर द फोर्स इज लेस द शॉर्टर फोर्स विल पुल अप लाइक दैट, तो जहाँ पे ज़्यादा फोर्स मिल रहा है तो ऑब्वियसली वो उसको पुशअप करेगा, और जो 2 वोल्ट का फोर्स है वो कम है, थोड़ा बहुत होल्ड करेगा, बट दिस 5 वोल्ट फोर्स इज हायर, सो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विल पास थ्रू दैट 2 वोल्ट एंड दे विल फ्लो इन अ फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन. So here you can say, so this I will be zero in this case because they are equipotential, but here the current will not be zero because the voltage difference is not zero. So whenever between two points voltage difference exists, you have the current flowing through the circuit. Okay. Now here try to understand in this case what is happening. Now here in this case I'll take the sif NMOS ka le raha hu main. So you will understand very properly. Now here you have VDD connected, correct? The output voltage means I'm taking for region 3. The output voltage here is VDD minus VTN. Say zyada hai, it is greater than that value. The output voltage is greater than this, and the threshold and what was your VGS value, gate to source voltage, so obviously this is your gate to source voltage, VGS also is, you have connected VDD here, you can see, but uska jo threshold voltage hai utna minus hoga wo, so VGS is also VDD minus VTN. Okay, so matlab yahan pe bhi ek voltage aa raha hai, aur I can say simply yahan pe aapka ek threshold voltage aa raha hai jo opposite direction mein connected hai like this way. Just to understand in a proper way, it is connected in negative way. मतलब ये VDD minus VTN यहाँ पे जो voltage आएगा वो, और यहाँ का already voltage VDD minus VTN, मतलब you can say output voltage is now greater than the input voltage. The current जो flow हो रहा था VDD से output की तरफ, why? Because your input यहाँ का जो voltage है output voltage से ज़्यादा था. ये concept understand करो. ये मतलब ये condition satisfy हो रही थी. The output voltage means the input voltage is greater than the output voltage. As soon as output voltage reaches to VDD minus VTN and becomes and crosses that value, the output voltage becomes greater than the VDD input side because your VTN jo hai usko kam kar raha hai. So output voltage now becomes lesser than this voltage. So uski wajah se kya hoga? Ab to reverse current flow hoga nahi. So obviously the transistor will go in a cutoff mode. Because आपका output voltage ज़्यादा हो गया तो it is equal to VDD, so output voltage, because that reason there will be no current flowing, because electrons cannot go reverse ना, मतलब electrons is flowing from source to drain and vice current flows from drain to source in NMOS, तो उल्टा तो नहीं जाएगा, इसलिए NMOS will go in the cutoff mode, okay, and PMOS will still remain in the linear region. So I hope you have understood this. And it will be there up to VDD because your capacitor will charge up to maximum voltage VDD. Understood? Understood the concept, all of you? Okay. So. Same thing is explained, and we can go to the next slide and we can just see here. It can be seen from figure that the drain to source and the gate to source voltage of the NMOS transistor are. Now, drain to source voltage, that is drain to VDS value, you know, drain to source voltage and gate to source voltage. Now, try to understand with the voltages. So, aur acche se samajh mein aayega. Wahi cheez ko. So, VDS of N, for NMOS we are talking about, huh? So drain to source voltage is VDD minus Vout, बिकॉज जो भी आपका वीडीडी इनपुट है और वी आउट आउटपुट वोल्टेज है उसका जो डिफरेंस आएगा वो आपका ड्रेन टू सोर्स पे एग्जिस्ट करेगा, करेक्ट? बिकॉज वीडीडी वी आर अप्लाइंग टू द ड्रेन एंड वी आउट इज द सोर्स साइड वोल्टेज, जो आपका कैपेसिटर चार्ज होने की वजह से वोल्टेज मिल रहा है. Now remember that V out whenever we are saying, so this V out is equivalent to the capacitor voltage. This is equivalent to capacitor voltage. Which is charging actually. So जो increase हो रहा है. So drain to source voltage will be input voltage minus output voltage, which is V out. And similarly, gate to source voltage, which is also will be equal to VDD minus V out, because आपका सोर्स जो वोल्टेज है वो चेंज होते जा रहा है ना. सो बिकॉज दैट रीजन एंड आपने गेट पे क्या वोल्टेज अप्लाई किया, वीडीडी अप्लाई किया. सो गेट टू सोर्स वोल्टेज विल बी वीडीडी माइनस वी आउट, बिकॉज आपका आउटपुट वोल्टेज चेंज हो रहा है. सो दस द एनमॉस ट्रांजिस्टर विल बी टर्न्ड ऑफ. दस और जब कभी भी आपका आउटपुट वोल्टेज इसको क्रॉस कर लेगा वीजीएस को तो ऑफ हो जाएगा. So thus the NMOS transistor will be turned off for V out is greater than VDD minus VTN. So वही बताया कट ऑफ में क्यों गया, because your VGS value also is VDD minus V out. As soon as V out becomes greater than VDD minus VTN, so क्या हो जाएगा, यहाँ पे put up कर दो V out की जगह पे VDD minus VTN अगर डाला तो क्या होगा, VDD VDD cancel हो जाएंगे और plus VTN, मतलब VGS is plus VTN. मतलब आपका गेट टू सोर्स वोल्टेज वी टी एन पे ही है, मतलब वो जस्ट वो ऑन होने की कंडीशन पे है, बट आपका आउटपुट वोल्टेज इज मोर देन दैट, मतलब वो नेगेटिव में चला जाएगा. मतलब आपका गेट टू सोर्स वोल्टेज में वी टी एन से भी कम वोल्टेज आएगा, मतलब वो अपने थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज जो गेट टू, मतलब एनमॉस के जो गेट पे थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज, मतलब जो वोल्टेज बचेगा वो दैट इज लेसर देन द थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज, सो इट विल गो इन द कट ऑफ and it will operate in the saturation mode for V out is less than VDD minus VTN. So same thing we have just explained in to the voltage. So you can see when your V out, so this is your V out. So when your V out is lesser than this point, so this point is VDD minus VTN, इससे कम है तो NMOS in saturation में है. And as soon as the output voltage crosses this VDD minus VTN, मतलब right side में गया तो NMOS goes in cut off directly. Same thing explained with the voltage. The VDS and VGS for the PMOS you can write here. So drain to source voltage for PMOS is V out minus VDD. It is same because, but remember that here it is V out minus VDD. Why? Because we are taking drain to source, not source to drain. So confusion hoga yahan pe, but understand this. Source to drain is this voltage, na? Because PMOS mein ulta hota hai na. Ye source hai, ye drain hai. तो आप वी एस डी लिखोगे तो इट इज वी डी डी माइनस वी आउट, बट वी आर राइटिंग ड्रेन टू सोर्स वोल्टेज, मीन्स उल्टा ले रहे ड्रेन टू सोर्स. सो ऑब्वियसली दिस वोल्टेज विल कम फर्स्ट माइनस दिस वोल्टेज. ओके, सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज रिटन वी डी आउट माइनस वी डी डी. आर यू एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई इट इज टेकन माइनस, मीन्स ऐसा क्यों लिया, समझ में आपको? बिकॉज पीमॉस में उल्टा होता है ना, सोर्स becomes drain and drain becomes source as in NMOS जो रहता है उसका उल्टा लेना आपको. So V drain to source means output voltage minus the input voltage. So this V out minus VDD and gate to source voltage of P is simply equal to minus VDD. Gate to source voltage of PMOS is minus of VDD. Suppose negative value of VDD will apply. Okay. Why minus? Because again I told you that we are taking gate to source. So here source is this one, है ना, मतलब एक्चुअल में हम लोग गेट टू सोर्स ले रहे हैं. तो गेट ये है, ये आपका गेट है और ये सोर्स है. तो जीरो माइनस वी डी डी, बिकॉज सोर्स वोल्टेज इज वी डी डी, सो जीरो माइनस वी डी डी इज माइनस वी डी डी, दैट इज अ गेट टू सोर्स वोल्टेज. समझ में आ रहा है ना, जीरो माइनस वी डी डी क्यों है वो, बिकॉज गेट टू वोल्टेज पे हम लोग जीरो ले रहे हैं. सो जीरो माइनस सोर्स वोल्टेज इज वी डी डी, सो जीरो माइनस VDD. समझ में आ रहा है, प्लीज रिप्लाई, बिकॉज दिस इज सिंपल कॉन्सेप्ट. बिकॉज यू नो VGS व्हेन यू राइट इज इक्वल टू VG वैल्यू माइनस सोर्स वैल्यू. सो फॉर PMOS योर VG इज जीरो एंड VS इज VDD, बिकॉज दैट रीजन वी गेट माइनस VDD. and drain to source output string here. Okay. So consequently, the PMOS transistor is in saturation for V out less than VTP. मतलब आपका output voltage जैसे VTP क्या threshold voltage of PMOS. So V out जैसे जब तक आपका VTC से कम रहेगा VTP से कम रहेगा तो वो saturation में रहेगा. And as soon as it crosses the VTP, it operates in the linear region for V out greater than VTP. Okay. This analysis has shown that we can identify three operating regions for CMOS transmission gate depending on the output voltage level. These operating regions are functions of V out. Obviously, the region have a function of V out. The V out voltage is a bad right. It is in saturation. Both will be in saturation up to VT of P. And between VTP, VT of P to VDD minus VTN, NMOS will be in a saturation while PMOS will become linear. While after VDD minus VTN, the NMOS directly goes in cutoff after from saturation to go to, it goes cutoff while VT, the PMOS will still remain in the linear phase. Okay. So the total current flowing through the transmission gate is sum of the NMOS drain current and the PMOS drain current. That you know, because current is a combination of both. So ID will be equal to IDS of N plus ID I of S D of P, correct? I of source to drain of P, okay? Remember that in PMOS, current flows because of the holes, you know? Holes give us a current flow. And in NMOS, current flows because of the electrons. So electron ka jo flow hai in NMOS mein, source to drain hota hai, iske liye we take the current from drain to source. Electrons opposite direction and holes flows from source to drain, so that's why we take the current direction same as source to drain only for the PMOS. Okay, so at this point we may devise an equivalent resistance for each transistor in this structure. So we can have the equivalent resistance. We can say R equivalent is equal to R equivalent for N. मतलब अगर उस transistor का जो equivalent resistance हम लोग निकाल सकते हैं, that will be equal to VDD minus V out upon ID S of N, and R equivalent of P will be simply equal to VDD minus V out upon I S D of P. Simple, and they are equal also. So the total equivalent resistance of the transmission gate relatively constant. So total equivalent resistance agar bolte hain during operation, it is remaining constant. That is, its value is almost independent of the output voltage. Whereas the individual, these are the individual resistance. अभी आप बोलोगे सर, यहाँ पे आपने बोला कि output almost independent of the outcomes, the resistance is almost independent of the output voltage, but that is for the equivalent resistance, only combined of transmission gate. But individually they are the function of the V out. So you can say, whereas the individually equivalent resistance of both NMOS and PMOS are strongly dependent on the output voltage. But in the combination, it is independent of the output voltage. So this property of CMOS transmission gate is naturally quite desirable. A CMOS pass gate, which is turned on by a logic high control signal, can be replaced by its simple equivalent resistance for dynamic analysis. So you can say, you can see here, when you are applying input voltage VDD, your gate terminals are high voltage. So you can see here it is high. So obviously, you have to invert karna aapko complementary, na? So this will be low. So obviously this will be on and current flows through the capacitor. Capacitor will charge. So during the on the condition, we can replace this transmission gate by a resistor. We can replace this transmission gate by a R equivalent resistance that you can see here. So switch will be there, which will be closed at t equal to zero, because at t equal to zero only your this pulses will be applied and transmission gate will be on and it will thus provide a small resistance to the output node. Okay, so for dynamic analysis it is given, but don't worry, the dynamic analysis is not there in the syllabus. Thus we have to understand transmission gate. There can be a question, 3D question, what is transmission gate? So you should draw the diagram and explain that three regions of operation with the diagram. Okay, so that graph is important if it comes in a theory question. Normally in exam you have the theory question, that one which I told you. So आपको transmission gate explain करना है, उसका operation explain करना है with that three regions of operation, or otherwise you may have the question implementation. You can implement the XOR gate or multiplexer by using transmission gates. So that we will do. Okay. So we'll start this last theory point. So the important point in transmission gate logic design is that a conducting transmission gate network low impedance path should always be provided. It's always there should be a low resistance path. Yeah, yeah, therefore. Conducting transmission gate network a low resistance path. मतलब आपका transmission gate on होना चाहिए. Should always be provided between the output node and the one of the inputs for all possible input combination. For all possible input combinations. Otherwise, what will happen? This is to make sure that the output node with its capacitive load is never left in a high impedance state. मतलब आपका हमेशा transmission gate on होना चाहिए. अगर off होगा तो क्या होगा? It goes in a high impedance state और capacitor वहाँ पे काम करना चालू कर देगा. मतलब आपके आगे के circuits में capacitor काम करना चालू कर देगा. You may be thinking, sir, why you are taking capacitor? But remember that capacitor, why we take? Because these are the parasitic capacitor जो exist होता है in between the two gates or two CMOS. So that we have to understand the behavior with capacitor, because parasitic capacitor is very important to consider, because they are the voltage storing devices. तो आपका अगर कहीं से पैरासिटिक कैपेसिटर बन गया तो वो वोल्टेज स्टोर करके रखता है. तो जो इसकी वजह से क्या होता है कि योर ऑपरेशन, योर स्टेबिलिटी, योर क्यू पॉइंट, योर ऑपरेशन ऑब्वियसली इट विल चेंज, बिकॉज यू हैव द सम ऑलरेडी एग्जिस्टिंग वोल्टेजेस विल बी देयर जो आपका ऑपरेशन को इफेक्ट करेगा. सो दैट्स व्हाई द कैपेसिटर, द पैरासिटिक कैपेसिटर्स आर टेकन इन द कंसिडरेशन. ओके, सो वी स्टार्ट विद द implementations of we are using the transmission gate to implement two input multiplexer. So we are going to start with some solved examples. Okay, so 2 input multiplexer also we have implemented using pass transistors. So by using transmission gate also we're going to implement that. Okay, so multiplexer is a digital circuit which selects one of the input based on the select line, so that you already know. So just for the theory purpose, it is given here. So it's a digital circuit which selects one of the inputs based on the select line. So two inputs hai to one select line will be there. So you can see the truth table here. So input, you have A and B. So A input A will be passed to the output when the select line is 0. And input B will pass to the output when the select line is 1. So your select line is the controlling input. So this is your controlling input. So this I'll connect to the gate of the transmission gate. So what is the expression you can represent? So you can say A we are getting when your S is equal to 0. So that's why A into S bar plus B we are getting when your S is equal to 1. So B into S. So this expression also we can directly get without solving the K-map all. Otherwise, directly has expression say hum log ko mil jata. So we can implement this using transmission gate, and we can understand the operation by this transmission gate. So now you can see there are two transmission gate. This one is one transmission, this one is another transmission gate. The input to the one transmission gate is A and this one is B. Now these are A and B, correct? Now the control signals, that is your gate ko hum log kya de rahe hain, वो आपका S दे रहे हैं ना. नाउ ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड वेदर वी आर गेटिंग द ऑपरेशन और नॉट. आई होप यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड ऑल्सो बाई योर सेल्फ ऑल्सो. जस्ट आई एक्सप्लेन यू दैट. नाउ टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ केस वन. वेन योर S इज इक्वल टू 0. सो वॉट विल हैपन? Your S is equal to 0, we have, so from here you will have 0 and it is inverted here, so you'll have 1 here. Okay, now this S equal to 0 will be applied. So kahan kahan connect hai, so ye directly yahan pe ja raha hai na. So yahan pe 0 ho gaya and ye yahan pe bhi ja raha hai, yahan pe bhi 0 ho gaya. So here also you'll have 0 and here you have 0. So now you can see here, this is your NMOS hai na, yahan pe bubble nahi hai, matlab ye NMOS hai. तो यहाँ पे अगर आपने जीरो दे दिया सो ऑब्वियसली दिस विल मेक दिस ट्रांसमिशन गेट ऑफ हाई इंपेडेंस स्टेट में चला जाएगा. अभी मतलब मैं सिर्फ एनमॉस को देख के बोल रहा हूँ, पीमॉस का भी चेक कर लेते हैं. नाउ यू हैव वन हियर, सो वन कहाँ पे कनेक्टेड है, नाउ यू कैन सी हियर वन इज कनेक्टेड हियर, सो ये भी आपका वन हो जाएगा और ये भी आपका वन हो जाएगा. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट नाउ यू कैन सी पीमॉस वी आर कनेक्टिंग वन वोल्टेज, मतलब हाई वोल्टेज है, सो दिस ऑल्सो विल बी इन कट ऑफ मोड, जिसकी वजह से ये क्या हो जाएगा, दिस ट्रांसमिशन गेट विल गो इन द सच मीन्स कट ऑफ मोड, मीन्स इट इज इन नॉट इन पिक्चर. वेल हियर यू कैन सी द अबाउट ट्रांसमिशन गेट to the NMOS we are connecting 1 and to the PMOS we are connecting 0 for the same condition. So this will be on and this A will be passed through the output. यहाँ से कुछ भी नहीं पास होगा because ये off है and ये on है. So your A will be passed through the output. Output will be A. Okay. Now we will so now you can see here F will be equal to or not F, we will take Y because मैंने Y लिखा output. Okay. So we'll take Y is equal to A. Okay. Now we will take another color and we understand the operation. Case 2. When your S is equal to 1. Now understand the circuit. Huh? This is very important. How it is drawn. So select line, kaise select kar rahe. Circuit bana diya to aapko operation samajhna easy hai. बट अगर मैंने आपको सिर्फ ये ट्रुथ टेबल दिया और बोला अभी सर्किट खुद से बनाओ, सो अंडरस्टैंड हाउ एक सर्किट कैसे ड्रॉ किया, तो वो लॉजिक यूज करके आप सर्किट कोई भी एक्सप्रेशन का बना सकते हैं. नाउ योर एस इज इक्वल टू वन, सो हियर यू हैव वन कनेक्टेड, सो दिस विल बी जीरो. ओके, नाउ दिस वन विल गो हियर, सो दिस विल बी वन, करेक्ट, एंड दिस वन विल ऑल्सो कम हियर, सो दिस विल बी वन, एंड दिस जीरो विल गो हियर, सो दिस इज जीरो. This is also zero. Okay. Now you can see here we are connecting PMOS. Upper wale mein one aa raha hai, to ye PMOS ko off karega. Aur yahan se kya aa raha hai, zero aa raha hai, to NMOS ko off karega. So this transmission gate will be in off condition. While here you can see here we have zero, so PMOS ko zero aa raha hai, to ye PMOS ko on karega. Aur yahan se one aa raha hai, to NMOS ko on karega. So this will be in on condition. So this B will be transferred to the output. So your output will be P. Okay. So Y is equal to B. I hope you have understood this. Remember that the exam mein straightforward question aayega. What is transmission gate? So just uska diagram bana ke aapko batana hai ki how the to matlab C or C bar leke batana hai condition or implement टू इनपुट मल्टीप्लेक्सर यूजिंग ट्रांसलेशन को. सो आपको ये टू टेबल बना के एक्सप्रेशन लिख के डायरेक्टली डायग्राम बनाओ, डोंट एक्सप्लेन द ऑपरेशन. ये ऑपरेशन जो मैं यहाँ पे एक्सप्लेन कर रहा हूँ दिस इज फॉर यू, ये आपके लिए है. अगर फिर भी यू वॉन्ट टू राइट इन एग्जाम सो राइट डाउन इन द शॉर्ट फॉर्म जैसे मैं लिख रहा हूँ, इट्स इनफ. ओके, सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस वन. नाउ वी कैन गो अहेड फॉर द सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल. Okay, so the operation can be understood very easily. If the control input signal S is logic high, so then the bottom transistor will conduct. So, dekha na, S equal to 1 liya to, S equal to 1 liya to, ye on ho jayega, ye off ho jayega, bottom transistor conducts and B is the output. And where S is equal to, output will be equal to B. And if when the control signal S is equal to 0, the up transistor will conduct and bottom transistor will be off. And the output will be equal to input A. So the same operation. Now we can go ahead and we can understand what is implementation of XOR gate using transmission gate. How we can implement XOR gate using transmission gate. Okay. So now XOR is a digital circuit which gives output low when both the inputs are same and high when the both inputs are different. So this you know. So output low when both the inputs are same. So that you know. आपका अगर दोनों इनपुट 0 0 या दोनों इनपुट 1 1 है तो आपका आउटपुट 0 आएगा बिकॉज दिस इज XOR एंड द आउटपुट विल बी 1 व्हेन बोथ द इनपुट्स आर डिफरेंट. है ना, मतलब एक भी 1 आ गया तो 1 और एक 0 आ गया, लाइक दैट वेज आउटपुट विल बी 1. ओके, इफ बोथ द इनपुट्स आर डिफरेंट then output is 1. If both the inputs are same, output is 0. So you can see here, when both the inputs are same, output is 0. When both the inputs are same, output is 0. And both the inputs are different, output is 1. Okay. So now, based on the which one to select, which one to take a select line. So we can say here A is taken as a select line. You can understand here. We can see here A is taken as a select line. Means A will be going to control the output, control the transmission gate. So now you can see here, when your A is 0, now you can understand here, when A is 0, the output is same as B. Same as when A is 0, the B is transferred to the output. And when your A is 1, B complement is transferred to the output. You can see this is B complement, and this is simply B. Okay. So when your A is 0, B is transferred to the output, and when your A is 1, B complement is transferred to the output. है ना? तो हम लोग दो transmission gate ले सकते हैं. Now I'll draw in a short way, so आपको अच्छे से समझ और भी थोड़ा अच्छे से समझ में आएगा. So I can take So one transmission gate, another transmission gate. Now one input we can give as B because that is one case. And then another input we can give as B bar, this is the second case. Now the here you have the PMOS and MOS, PMOS and NMOS. The output will be combination of both, which is your Y. Now this B will be on when your A is 0. So A is 0 matlab aap yahan pe kya doge, A complement doge. So this will be A bar and this will be A, correct? Sorry, ulta ho gaya. This should be A, बिकॉज ए जीरो रहेगा तो ऊपर वाला ऑन होना चाहिए ना. एज लेस देन वन मिनट इज रिमेनिंग, आई जस्ट स्टॉप द शेयर, विल इम्प्लीमेंट दिस इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन. सो आई रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन टू टेक अ ब्रेक ऑफ 5 मिनट, जॉइन एट 10:30. दिस विल टेक फॉर 20 मिनट्स, नॉट मोर देन दैट. ओके, विल टेक फॉर 20 मिनट्स, आई विल गिव यू द ब्रेक ऑफ 10 मिनट्स आफ्टर दैट. ओके, सो जॉइन एट 10:30.